Hello, my name is Iordanis Evangelou, and I'm a PhD student at the Athens University of Economics and Business. This is a presentation of our work on rasterization-based progressive photon mapping. Rendering high-fidelity images is a challenging task when difficult-to-capture illumination events are present in the scene. One such case arises, for instance, when we would like to simulate lighting phenomena such as caustics. To handle this type of events, algorithms that discover paths from the light sources to the camera sensor in a bidirectional manner, such as the photon mapping and its several variants, have been introduced and extensively researched in computer graphics. Photon mapping was first introduced by Jensen and consists of two main steps. First, a massive number of photons is emitted from the light sources, traced throughout the scene, depositing flux contribution to certain light scattering events. Then, in the second step, paths, traced from the camera, gather a fixed number of photons in the local neighborhood around diffuse events. As the number of emitted photons tends to infinity, the photon mapping algorithm can produce accurate output radiance estimates. In practice, though, the generation of converged images requires a huge number of photons, resulting in large storage and indexing requirements. For this reason, Hatsuk and colleagues further refined the algorithm in order to lift the prohibitive cost induced from the photon storage. In contrast to the original method, the camera path tracing pass is invoked first, storing a number of importants dependent only on the image resolution, which represent the hit points where photon gathering is going to occur. Then, photons are iteratively emitted in batches and traced, contributing to the stored importants in every iteration. This iterative photon emission process allows for arbitrary large populations of photons. Coupled with the statistical shrinking of the photon gathering radius, the proposed mechanism ensures a high quality and consistent output with a low memory footprint. Progressive photon mapping was further improved independently by Hatsuk and Jensen, as well as Naus and Zeger, that unified both the camera and light stages. This effectively reduced the variance for certain illumination effects and greatly simplified several aspects of the algorithm. Instead of relying on local statistics at each important for the constriction of the gathering radius, a global rate is used for the entire scene. Additionally, the important generation step is now also performed in an iterative fashion, allowing for a more flexible exploration of the path space by stochastically computing new importants. However, this comes at the cost of requiring either an important or a photon index to be rebuilt per iteration to perform nearest neighbor search during photon density estimation. Our work builds on the generalized probabilistic approach of the progressive photon mapper proposed by Naus and Zeger. To recap, the most recently proposed progressive variants of photon mapping require a constant and relatively low amount of memory at the cost of reconstructing the photon or important hierarchy in every subsequent iteration. Traditionally, the indexing mechanism is handled by some hierarchical data structure such as a KD tree, which provides efficient queries at the cost of a slow construction time. This can induce a high cost to the overall process in terms of application interactivity and responsiveness, which in turn makes its practical usage limited. Ideally, our indexing scheme should rank both resource conservation and speed equally. Taking these factors into consideration and exploiting a ubiquitous pipeline that is independent of the GPU architecture such as the rasterization pipeline, the hierarchy construction can be replaced with a highly parallel process in order to resolve the gathering step but at the same time maintain query performance. Consequently, in this work, we focus on unifying both tracing and photon energy distribution stages under the hood of the rasterization pipeline. This will enable us to implicitly couple the important storage with the tracing architecture and fully utilize splatting, a highly parallel process to effectively distribute photon energy flux. As a result, construction of a photon hierarchy can be completely omitted. This is in sharp contrast to prior rasterization-based photon mapping approaches, as our method is the first to demonstrate a faithful and accurate porting of the algorithm to the rasterization pipeline that captures every illumination event without approximations and energy loss. Before we delve into the details of our method, it is essential to get a high-level overview of some rasterization-based data structures. In their simplest form, image-based methods are specialized in capturing view-dependent geometry samples at a predefined granularity, corresponding to the image plane resolution in pixel units. Projected samples generate fragments that may overlap in image space and thus require a per-pixel storage mechanism to maintain. Therefore, these fragments can be directly used to index the actual primitives in the scene. By appropriately extending a single view to a multi-view storage scheme, we can effectively index the whole input geometry. In the special case of a perspective projection, One can achieve this by constructing six partially overlapping views in a cube of formation. Recently, Vardis and colleagues introduced a ray tracing architecture, abbreviated to DERT, that exploits the aforementioned spatial subdivision to accurately resolve potential triangle intersections. Briefly speaking, they used a hierarchical image-based traversal algorithm to efficiently match rays across the views of the cube map and index the actual geometry by iterating a per-pixel storage scheme. In order to perform shading and keep tracing rays at arbitrary depth, their method maintained a per-pixel heat buffer that recorded the IDs of intersected primitives. In a secondary step, geometry was rasterized into the cube map to extract the shading data for each intersection and update the payloads of the corresponding rays. Our method exploits the presence of this heat buffer to store traced particles and perform splatting at arbitrary camera or light path nodes. Let us now proceed to the specific steps of our algorithm. First, we begin with the photon emission states. A linear buffer is initialized with the number of entries equal to the emitted photons times the maximum trace depth. Next, we invoke the photon tracing path. For each photon, an additional path segment is traced along with an update of the corresponding photon entry. Optionally, in this step, certain types of light emitters, such as point lights, can utilize the rasterizer to employ a fast direct photon bounce, effectively omitting the tracing step. This stage is terminated when the maximum trace depth or a path termination event is encountered for every emitted photon. After the photon tracing phase, we can partially evaluate the indirect illumination visible from the eye sensor on diffuse surfaces. This can be accomplished with a splatting operation on surface points directly visible from the camera. More specifically, every indirectly scattered photon can be treated as a primitive and rasterized on the camera image plane with splat size equal to the important gathering radius. Generated fragments will index and accumulate photon energy contributions using the camera G-buffer. Due to the inherent parallelization provided by the rasterization, this method effectively replaces a tree search invocation with a constant time indexing mechanism. Up to this step, we have only recorded the contribution of photons using only the light tracing step. Since gathering can only occur on diffuse surfaces, we have demonstrated how to evaluate part of the final indirect illumination. This only accounts for path segments connecting the light source to diffuse surfaces directly visible from the camera. Surfaces visible to the camera sensor indirectly via highly directional scattering, such as reflection and refraction, do not contribute to the output, however. Thus, secondary paths must be traced from the camera to capture these events and subsequently terminate on diffuse surfaces in order to effectively enable the gathering process. Since we use DERT to trace the importance, successful surface intersections are implicitly recorded from its heat buffer and as a result, no extra storage and indexing mechanisms are required. Active important heats for the current trace depth can now be indexed by splatting indirectly scattered photons into the DERT cube map. This is a necessary operation as importance may not be directly visible to the camera after the secondary bounce. It is important to note that photon splat projections are independent of the cube map resolution and therefore the latter does not introduce any approximations to the final flux distribution. Resolution only affects the sparsity and the length of the heat records. Repeating these two stages until a diffuse event or a maximum depth is reached will be sufficient to completely simulate every missing illumination path. Finally, accumulating direct illumination and averaging the final rendering output will complete a single iteration of our photon mapper. For the evaluation part of our method, we performed experiments on 7 different scenes with geometric complexity ranging from a few thousand over a million triangles. As for the photon emission size, we employed batches of approximately 250,000 photons for each test case. In order to compare the performance and quality of our method, we implemented a reference probabilistic progressive photon mapper using the optics ray tracing framework and CUDA-FLAN, a GPU accelerated library for nearest neighbor searches via KD trees. For both implementations, we ran tests on an NVIDIA RTX 2080. First, we illustrate for each test case an average time for a complete iteration of the photon mapping process at various lengths of light and eye paths. As we can observe, despite the generally slower ray traversal of DERT compared to the optimized optics ray tracing engine, our method has a significantly better overall performance due to two important factors. First, our photon mapping variant does not require any photon index construction. Second, the introduction of photon splatting instead of gathering at all path depths outperforms a tree search operation due to its trivially parallel fragment-based execution. Next, we investigated the performance impact induced as the emitted batch size varies from approximately 60,000 to 500,000 photons for both methods. Despite that image-based photon tracing takes a significant portion of time for a single photon mapping cycle, the FLAN index construction query has a considerable overhead, resulting in noticeably higher cycle times in all cases. We also investigated the performance of both methods in different resolutions up to 4K with constant photon path size. The same behavior is observed as image space in photon tracing is heavily affected by the increasing resolution. Nevertheless, the overhead induced primarily by the queries of the FLAN KD tree overshadows our method's total cycle time. To emphasize the above, we show here example renderings, demonstrating the higher image quality that our method delivers for equal rendering time. And, since we employ analytical array intersection tests, combined with accurate photon energy distribution through the splatting operation, we can guarantee that the final result is consistent with the reference method. Finally, since the reconstruction of our geometry acceleration data structure can be performed in interactive frame rates, we would like to briefly demonstrate the interactive aspect of our method on two example scenes. First, a closed room illuminated from a periodically rotating spotlight. And second, a procedurally animated geometry. Concluding this talk, we have presented a high-performance and accurate probabilistic progressive photon mapper for the rasterization pipeline. By exploiting the parallel capabilities of the available hardware, the splatting operation in conjunction with the implicit handle of the important storage from DIRT can be used as a very efficient alternative for the gathering process. This effectively eliminates the photon map hierarchy and at the same time is capable of capturing every illumination event. Nevertheless, these benefits come at some cost. Since our method augments the DIRT architecture, it is therefore directly dependent on its specifics. For more details about our work as well as related topics, we highly recommend the interested audience to check out our research group webpages. Thank you.